All right, so this was part A of, or the first four subsections or clauses of section 9. Last three clauses of section 9 subsection 1 are this. Okay, interest, royalty and fees for technical service. Interest, royalty and fees for technical service. On these three items, there is a global fight going on versus globe versus India. Okay, because in 1991 when Dr. Manmohan Singh became finance minister for the first time, okay, he was the best finance minister we had. Okay, he roamed across the globe like Modi uncle is roaming now, and he brought all foreign brands in India. Okay, that time, before that, in India foreign companies were taxed at the rate of 80%, 80. Okay, so do you think foreign companies will enter into India? That was the intention, that they should not enter in India. By keeping high amount of tax rate, what was our intention? They should not, because how Britishers came, East India Company, and they ruled on us. So all those things were there. Gandhiji said, no, now nation, Swadeshi and all. So foreign companies were not welcome before 1991. Our economy was closed economy. Okay. In 1991, we brought open economy concept again by launching those economical concept, if you know, LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. Globalization means India going global and globe coming to India. That's globalization. All right. And globalization, then foreign companies came, said, and we cannot come to India because you are having horrible tax rates. All right. Manmohan Singh uncle promised them that we will give you best concessional tax rates possible. Sometime 20%, sometime 5%, and some in some case scenario 10%. So 5, 10, 20. These were the different categories. All right. Royalty per se, it was taxable at 10%. This royalty was taxable at 10%. Okay. Interest sometime taxable at 5%. Fees for technical service, which is known to you guys as the technical know-how. Okay. See, you have seen Hero Honda bikes and all, right? Before that, we had only one company in India. Okay, Hamara Bajaj. Hamara Bajaj and all those. Two-wheeler market was not there. Everybody had dreamed to buy cycle, Hero cycle. Alright, so Hero was into cycles. Hero was not into bikes. Honda came and Honda said, we will teach you how to make bikes. We will give our technical know-how. Hello? For that, we will charge you technical fees. Now, Honda is in Japan, Hero is in India, foreign company giving technical services to India, and Indian company giving payment to foreign company. You tell me whether that foreign company should pay tax on this income which is going to them from India. Yes, because source is located in India. I did not say the company which is paying is the Indian company. I said source is located in India. That's important. The tree they planted in India. You see MACD here? Foreign company. Yes or no? Franchise they have given, their royalty they have given. How to make those French fries they have given, that technology they have given. KFC. How to fry that chicken, that is the technology that they have. Know how they have. Coca-Cola. PepsiCo, all these are foreign companies. Hindustan Unilever, all these are foreign companies. You understand? They have come to India with their own name, their own brand, and they are charging royalty income from us. Alright, so majority foreigners are earning these three income from us. Majority globe. Alright, and taxing these three was always a disputable. It is a disputable, it will be disputable in future. But government, by implementing section 9.1 and some clauses here, they at least restored the faith of foreign people in India. So what Dr. Manmohan Singh did, he gave very concessional rate to all these foreigners. So they came in India, they invested hundreds of crores. Then his government was removed in 1996. In 1997, P. Chidambaram uncle became finance minister. And he said, itna benefit tumko? Kaika 10%, 25% minimum. Concessional but 25. Now what? How foreigner will feel? You showed us gajar, na gajar dikhana bolte na, of 10%, we came, and now you are slapping at this with 25%, which is completely unfair, which was unfair, yes or no?
Yes.
Alright, but he did it, he said India need taxes, You are earning crores of rupees. You pay 25%. No, we are not taking 80%. We are also not taking 40%, which is the general rate of tax. Special rate for you guys, but 25. So 10 went to 25. Then Arun Jaitley uncle came now, BJP time, all right, and he again brought down those rates to 10%. Because Modi uncle is going abroad and saying, please, make in India, please, digital India, please invest in India, skill India. So when you are saying that, they say, no, 25%, no. So we said, no, again we will give you, you have to pay tax, that I cannot exempt, but concessional, 5%, 10%, that's okay, yes or no? This is a CMA final syllabus, again. But here you must understand what is deemed to accrued in India. If source is located in India, then accrued in India. If source is not located in India, then not accrued in India. So I'm Indian, Ram Patil. I took loan from USA and I invested in my project in Nepal. Please understand. Borrower kahan pe hai? India. Lender kahan pe hai? Money kahan pe apply hua? Nepal mein. Accrue kahan pe ho raha hai? Interest accrue kahan pe ho raha hai? India mein ki Nepal mein salo? जहाँ पैसा जहाँ पेड़ लगेगा वहाँ पे आपको अक्रू होगा ना. पेड़ कहाँ पे लगाया? वहाँ पे अक्रू यहाँ पे होगा. कैसा पेड़ लगाया तुम लोगों ने? प्लांटेशन नहीं समझ में आ रहा है लोगों को. आई टुक मनी फ्रॉम यूएसए. आई एम जस्ट ऑर्डिनरी रेसिडेंट बट आई प्लांटेड ट्री इन. इज इट गेटिंग अक्रूड इन इंडिया? दैट प्रोजेक्ट जनरेटिंग कैश फ्लो इन इंडिया और इन नेपाल? सो दैट इंटरेस्ट इज नॉट टैक्सेबल इन इंडिया. ऑल दैट इज पेड बाय रेसिडेंट. Although it is paid by resident. Okay. Hello. Whether it is a resident or non-resident doesn't make any difference. Okay. Now another example. A Japanese guy taking loan from China. But he invested that money in India. Now borrower and lender both are non-resident. But money was in India. That technology is in India. That royalty that you are getting is getting accrued in India or from the project in India. Indian accrued income. Sir, wo Japanese guy agar France mein lagata to India ka kya lena dena? Japanese guy taking loan from China, applying in France. Not taxable in India.
Yes.
Alright, because you should focus here on source, because accrue means source. I'm not talking about receipt rule. I'm not talking about residence rule. I'm applying only one rule here, and that is source rule. This is source rule. You must follow the source. You should look at the source. If that source is in India, tu resident rewe, non-resident rewe, tu Bhagwan rewe. It will be taxable in India. Am I clear? Okay. So look at the way of writing it. So you have to write these three items. From three items, you will take one common arrow. And that common arrow is again divided into three different part. Who is payer, sir? Who is paying you all this thing? This is paid by paid to foreigners. By whom? This is buyer. Who is paying them? This is outside India. See, if these people are earning in India, then we don't need deeming section for that. Actually, you are earning here. We are deeming it because you people are earning it and you are outside India and you are confused. I am here, should it be taxable? Yes. Why? It is deemed to be accrued in India. Kya sir? Interest, royalty, fees for technical service, payable by. So, teen bar payable nahi likhne ka, ek hi bar likho na. Payable by. Samjha apko? Payable by whom? NR. NR nahi bhi diya tabhi bhi. Unka question kya tha? Japanese is paying interest to Chinese, sir. Will it be taxable? Yes, because project is in India. Japanese paying interest to Chinese, but chalega project kidhar hai? India mein. So actually aise ja raha hai na? Alright, money yahan se yahan gaya, wahan se money yahan aaya, ab yahan se money yahan ja raha hai. So project yahan pe, source yahan pe, India mein source hai, to tax lagega. Government de raha hai, to abhi bhi mera government of India tujhko paisa de raha hai, government of India. Salary ki bhi baat ho gayi. Salary was paid by government. You are in USA, you are in Canada, but salary was paid by? So there are source kahan hai? Government. India yahan pe hai. So you have to pay taxes. Okay. And person resident in India. So resident ho ya? Non-resident ho. Okay. Yahan tak samajh mein aa raha hai? Sir, non-resident ka kab? Yahan pe dekho. Next. If money borrowed मनी बोरोड एंड यूज फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ बिजनेस एंड प्रोफेशन कहाँ पे? इन इंडिया. और जो प्रोजेक्ट टेक्निकल नो हाउ लिया आपने वो कहाँ पे अप्लाई किया है? टेक्निकल सर्विसेज आर यूटिलाइज फॉर द बिजनेस एंड प्रोफेशन और एनी सोर्स इन इंडिया. तुम समझ रहे हो यूज कौन सा वर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट है? यूज. यूज कहाँ पे होना चाहिए? इंडिया में. तो सोर्स कहाँ पे आ जाएगा? इंडिया में. ओके तू कोई भी रहे, फिर पेयर कोई भी रहे, रिसीवर कोई भी रहे, प्रोजेक्ट कहाँ पे है, यूज कहाँ पे हुआ है, देन इट इज टैक्सेबल इन इंडिया, इट्स इंडियन इनकम. ओके पक्का सर. लास्ट पार्ट, पर्सन इन रेसिडेंट. सो बाय डिफॉल्ट इफ रेसिडेंट इज पेइंग यू देन बाय डिफॉल्ट ऑब्वियसली रेसिडेंट इन इंडिया, सो इट विल बी टैक्सेबल इन इंडिया. बट नाउ एक्सेप्शन, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड एक्सेप्शन. एक्सेप्शन मीन्स पेयर, पेयर इज रेसिडेंट, राम पाटिल जोगेश्वरी में है, बट माई प्रोजेक्ट इज इन नेपाल एंड उधर से पैसा दे रहा हूँ यूएसए को. हेलो, इज इट टैक्सेबल जस्ट बिकॉज पेयर इज रेसिडेंट? सोर्स कहाँ पे है? नेपाल में है ना, देयरफॉर एक्सेप्शन. ये एक्सेप्शन वर्ड रेडिंग में लिखना है. दिस इज एक्सेप्शन टू अक्रू, एक्सेप्शन टू डीम टू अक्रू. मतलब ये डीम नॉट टू अक्रू है, ये नहीं है यहाँ पे, इंडिया नहीं है, इंडियन इनकम नहीं है, ये दो आइटम इंडियन इनकम नहीं, एक्सेप्शन पड़ा रहा. बाय डिफॉल्ट रेसिडेंट ने दिया तो अक्रूड. एक्सेप्शन कब आएगा? देखो, व्हेन द मनी बोरोड और टेक्निकल सर्विस आर यूज फॉर एनी बिजनेस और प्रोफेशन कैरी आउट किधर? आउटसाइड. तो एक्सेप्शन है. इन इंडिया होगा तो अक्रू है, आउटसाइड इंडिया होगा तो नहीं है. ओके, सेम उधर भी आउटसाइड इंडिया. ओके समझा? तो जब आउटसाइड और इन लिखते हो, इन इंडिया, ये दो वर्ड को कैसे लिखना है? रेडिंग. ओके, वही मेन वर्ड है यहाँ पे. यहाँ पे इन इंडिया है और वहां पे ये टैक्सेबल है और ये टैक्सेबल नहीं है. ओके गुड.